Hey guys, it's Becky with Design Bundles, and I am back today to talk to you about using your PixScan mat with your Cameo 4. Now, if you don't have a Cameo 4, that's okay, because the processes are going to be the same regardless of which Cameo you're on, and you can use the same mat. So, definitely something we're going to experiment with today. The PixScan mat is not known for being easy to use. So many of you that are here may be here because you're hoping that we will share some troubleshooting tips with you. Now, I do not have a very large arsenal of troubleshooting tips, but I will definitely share anything and everything that I can. So let's go ahead and jump over to Silhouette Studio and we will get started.
Okay guys, so here we are in Silhouette Studio, and what I want to do, the second icon down is for my PixScan panel. And this is going to give me all the tools that I need to be able to use the PixScan mat. The only other thing that I need is some sort of device to take a picture. Now, I used my cell phone. I'm sure you could use a tablet or something along those lines, okay? And what I did was I put all of the vinyl on my PixScan mat, and then I took a picture of the mat. Now, I'll be honest with you, I did not pay too much attention to what was in the background, or rather what I had laid it on, because I thought, oh, I'll just crop it down, no big deal. But you actually don't want to do that, and you're going to understand why in just a minute, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you what I originally went through. I'm going to go to Import PixScan Image from File, and I'm in my Downloads folder. Now, see, here's my crop down picture. But what I actually want is the original picture. Now I import that in and it says, wait. There's no calibration profile for this. Of course, I'm like, really, Silhouette? It's just pick up the mat. Let's just be done with it. But, you know, I guess it needs to calibrate. I don't really know what calibrate means, to be honest with you, other than it was actually a little on the spooky side. And let me tell you why. All right, so I canceled that. So you're going to come down here to show calibration test card. And I do have it set to letter size. Now, for whatever reason, that switches me over to a portrait size mat. I don't know that it makes a difference, but I wasn't working on a portrait for this one here. So I switched it back to a Cameo size mat. Let me show you there. Okay, so Cameo size mat. Go back to my PixScan panel, and what you're going to do is you're going to print this right here, this calibration card, you're going to print it on your printer. Now, Becky, what happens if you don't have a printer? I don't have an answer for that, other than you could save it as a PDF and have it printed or send it to a friend to be printed, okay? But I do know that you need to print this out because you are going to take a picture of this with your cell phone. Now, why? It's part of the calibration. I don't know the specifics of it, but watch, it's actually really pretty cool. So I took a picture of it, and I'm going to show you the little video I did while I was taking a picture of it. So what you want to do after it prints, now this is printed on a letter size sheet, and what you're seeing is a screen recording from my phone. I have a Samsung Note 10 Plus. And what you want to do is you want to you want to use your phone and get as close to the sheet. You want no edges showing. Okay, so no edges showing at all on the top, bottom, or the sides. And take a picture. So now you can upload that and email it to yourself. Okay, so then what I did was I imported that picture. Now, when we're talking about importing the picture from my cell phone, you can email those to yourself. I actually use Google Photos. So right after I take the picture, I can upload it to the cloud, walk over to my computer, and it's already there. So then I can just download it. So whatever works for you. But that's what I do. I use Google Photos. Now I'm going to come down here. I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to hit plus. And this right here is the picture of my calibration card. Test card, and I'm going to bring that in. And do you see what happened? Like, I don't know why I thought this was kind of creepy, but I was like, wait a minute, how do they know just from the picture that I had a Samsung phone? Now, it doesn't bother me enough to actually research that, but you can rename it. We'll say Becky's Note 10 Plus. And, you know, I guess it only matters as a reminder if I were to be using a different cell phone. If I get a new cell phone, maybe I decide to do this with my iPad. I don't know. But there we go. I named it. And then what I'm going to do, come back up here, import PixScan image from file. Now I'm going to open this up. Like I said, I tried to use that crop down file originally. But I think what it does is it has to do with that calibration, and it needs the full size of your, the full size of your image. And then literally, do you see what happened? It was kind of like magic. It was a magic moment. And we jumped over from our PixScan calibration to an exact image of our PixScan mat. So I'm pretty impressed with that. And I really like it a lot. So then from here, I'm going to go to File and Merge. And I want to bring in, it looks like I didn't unzip it yet. But I want to cut this gingerbread man. And that's why I picked the colors that I did, because I thought we would make a male and female. We'll call them husband and wife. We'll make a husband and wife set in the gingerbread man. Right, here we go. And let's see, I want to view large icons. Okay, so there's the kits. So let's see, what's in number one? There we go. So number one is my gingerbread people. There's my SVG. Okay. And then I want to bring in some accessories. All right, so I'm going to bring in the caps. I think those are cute. The shirts didn't do anything for me, but the scarves did. We will do some spectacles. I don't know exactly if I will use them, but I mean, you know, let's go ahead and bring them in, and I can always delete them if I need to. All right, we definitely want the little arm squiggles, the feet squiggles. That was the wrong one. Sorry, just kidding. Feet squiggles. We need some faces. So what faces do we want? Okay, so I will do, we'll do face number three for the girl, and we'll just do face number one for the boy. Almost done, guys, I swear. And I really, really love the gloves, so let's do some of those. Okay, so let's go ahead. We need to start ungrouping these, because they do come in grouped, and while that's all fun and good, I don't really think that, I don't know, maybe I'm wrong. I was going to say, I don't think they're coming in the right size, but they actually look like the right size. But I do want to be able to go through and make some adjustments. And I am going to cut two gingerbread people. All right, now the first thing I want to do, so these are truly scraps. These are scraps that I dug out of my scrap pile. So I need to make sure that my gingerbread man is going to fit on my scrap. Okay, and they do. All right, so now let's talk about accessories. I'm going to be honest with you, I may not do those faces. I think the eyes are creeping me out a little bit. Okay, so ungroup, and we will do one scarf for her. Now, I'm not going to use these, and let me tell you why. These pieces are still going to be relatively small, and I don't think that these details would cut well. So we are going to do solid color scarves. Let's see. And I really like how you can kind of see, like, the texture. You can see that I have kind of a bubble going on there. And let's ungroup these. And I'm actually going to release compound path, and we'll do one purple. And what's that, like a mint? And let's do, these are feet and hands over there. All right, so we will, I'm going to switch this out. And then let's see, this is orange. So let's do one orange set and one green set. And then same thing here. Let's do one green set and pink set. There we go. Yeah, I'm going to leave those off. I'm going to leave all those off. So there we go. So this is what I'm going to cut. I'm going to cut my tan gingerbread man outlines. And then I'm going to cut the sweater and hats. Oh, the gloves. Who doesn't need gloves? You know, that's what I'm saying. I guess we'll do these gloves up here. Okay, so there, I have arranged all of my little pieces, and what I'm going to do is click over to send. Now, this process is going to be just like cutting with a regular mat. You're going to select your material, which is going to be, in my case, vinyl glossy. My action is cut. My tool is going to be, all right, make sure that actually switches over to cut. My tool is going to be a ratchet blade. I don't use an auto blade. And what I'll do is I'm going to walk over and load this into my Cameo and go ahead and cut. Okay?
So let's go ahead and hit the pause button, because it is very important for me to tell you that this was the hardest project tutorial I have done in a really long time. Now you may be asking why. You guys know that the Cameo 4 is a pretty recent addition to my little crafting arsenal, and I had a really, really, really hard time getting it to register the marks on my PixScan mat. So if you've not seen before, this is a PixScan cutting mat. Okay, and similar to print and cut, you have registration marks along the sides, the top, the bottom, okay? Now, I tried everything that I could find, you know, since we last spoke to each other. I added more light, because light is very crucial to using the registration marks. So I understand that. So I added light. When I mean like added light, it was literally like, I cannot get this light any closer. I added light. I tried it with shutting the lid. I tried taking new calibration photos. I tried taking new photos of my mat, and I tried better lighting in my photos. And what all did I try? I feel like I tried over and over. And so what my machine was doing was it would register this registration mark, scroll down, register this registration mark, scroll up, pause, do nothing, scroll all the way back here, and then tell me that the registration marks had failed. So I knew that the optical lens was picking up both of these, but something was going on when I got over here. Now, I tried restarting the software. I restarted my machine. I disconnected everything and let them sit for about an hour. And I ran through the gauntlet of everything that's recommended when you're having errors using your PixScan mat. Now, let me say, what I ended up doing was I upgraded my software to a 4.4 version of Silhouette Studio. Then literally, I came straight over here, put it in, it registered and cut beautifully on the very first cut. And then I tried another one after that, and it went back to doing the right same thing. So I'll be honest with you, we're gonna have to keep experimenting with the PixScan mat. Given a choice, and that's where I'm going with all this, because I searched YouTube and I'm like, somebody has to have the answer. I searched Google, I searched Facebook, I searched I polled other licensed silhouette instructors. I'm like, somebody has to know what's going on here. Everything came back with a big fat negative. Most of them had never even heard of that type of error. Okay, so where I'm going with this is just an honest, straightforward review. Given a choice, I would not use a PixScan mat ever again. Now, that's not really fair, because there are a lot of reasons why you would use a PixScan mat, okay? It's really great for using scraps like this. It's really great for contour cutting if you have shapes and items that you want to cut a design onto, really odd shapes, all right? That's what's gonna be the most beneficial. Or if you have pattern paper or fabric and you need to cut in a specific area of that fabric. Okay, I mean, lots of really great ideas. I promise. There are great ideas for the PixScan mat. They're just not going to be ideas that I will pursue in the future until I reclaim the calm that the PixScan mat kinda sucked out of me a little bit, okay? Now, I'm gonna go ahead and proceed with the project, but I absolutely could not do this video without telling you the experiences that I had and to let you know if you have these experiences, you are not alone, okay? Now, if you've encountered this error and you would like to share with the class on what worked for you, please, you know, I always welcome your comments. So let's go ahead and move forward. I'm gonna show you my cuts. We're gonna finish the project and then I'll do the wrap up of using the PixScan mat. Okay, so here we are. This is our famed PixScan mat. All right, and I'm just going to go through and weed all of the vinyl. I'm gonna weed it right here on the mat because several of these pieces were curled up in the beginning. So I don't really wanna have to fight uncurling those. Okay, so with my vinyl weeded, I'm going to measure out some transfer tape. And then if you know me, you know that I like to layer using the transfer tape, but we're gonna try something a little bit different today because I've seen some other crafters doing this and I wanna give it a try. So I'm gonna start with, so this is a medium tack transfer tape here. Okay, so it's not gonna be as easy to get my items up and going. Okay, but it's going to allow me, if I do this right, to put my vinyl down and peel the transfer tape back off. Now, that probably doesn't seem important to a lot of people, and I mean, really, in the big scheme of things, for most projects, I prefer to line everything up on my transfer tape. But for this one in particular, I thought it would be useful because I didn't have these set up in a way that was conducive to lining it up on my transfer tape. Okay, so I'm just gonna go through one by one and create my little gingerbread people, my little husband and wife set. Actually, if you get tired of messing with the transfer tape, you can place these kind of like stickers. I say that because this is holographic adhesive vinyl, so it's more sturdier than some other types of adhesive vinyl. I better move this guy over, otherwise they're gonna be holding hands. Okay, so obviously they do not have a lot of details. I didn't do eyes, I didn't do any of the buttons down the middle because I was doing the scarf. So if you're a fan of snowmen, I do definitely recommend this bundle, especially because, I mean, hello, it's a freebie, right? But just be prepared that there are definitely a lot of little pieces for you to add to it and decorate it and make your own, which is a plus. I love these types of products where I get all the accessories and then, for example, if I have 5 children, I can make different gingerbread for each child. So, definitely love these a lot. If you're wondering, all of these are holographic adhesive vinyl, and the one that I used underneath is the copper metallic from Oracle. So, that is all I got for this project today. So let's go ahead and jump over and we will do the recap. So, how did you feel about our little gingerbread men? Now, I think they turned out really cute, although they're very simplistic, and that's okay. You know, a lot of times it doesn't take a lot of fancy detail to make a cute project, right? Okay, now let's circle back around to this PixScan mat because I do not like to leave things on a negative note. So I already told you a few of the things that I tried. I tried increase in the lighting. I also tried increase in the lighting in my photos. I actually, it was recommended, and I didn't mention this before, that when you're taking your calibration and your matte photos, because remember those are two different photos, to make sure that you get it as straight as possible. So you want to take your phone and get it, try to parallel it with your cutting mat and your calibration sheet, okay? So definitely tried that. And I just feel like if you work yourself through the steps, most people will eventually figure out what it is that is holding them back and struggling using the PixScan mat. All right. And of course, there's also more and more tutorials coming out. There's more and more people learning and using the PixScan mat. So I'm very hopeful that we will be able to come back and give you a better update and say, hey guys, we know how to use the PixScan mat now. I'm just kidding. We did eventually get it to work, obviously, you saw. And I'll admit, once I got it to work, I mean, it was really easy. It cut my vinyl great. It made it super easy to line up my pieces on the mat so that I had the proper alignment. It's great for using scraps. This would also be great if you were going to use print and cut a lot. This is a way that you can do print and cut without doing the registration marks on your page. Okay, that could be a big deal to some people who want to be able to print and cut and use their full page availability. Am I right? So, okay, I'm going to stop babbling on, but hopefully you'll take some of those tips to heart if you're here joining us and, you know, kind of work through some of our troubleshooting steps. And of course, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments. I welcome any comments you want to share with me on this video, because I love that we are one big crafting community and we're not afraid to share with each other. Just like I'm not afraid to tell you, hey, this kind of wasn't my favorite. So, but these are things that we are putting in our crafting arsenal, and we can use them if we need to in the future. And that's what it's all about, is storing that knowledge for later. So, all right, I'm getting off track. Thanks for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. And make sure you subscribe to the channel so that when we come back with more tutorials for you, you get all this great information right at your fingertips. So thanks again. I really appreciate it. We will see you next time.